again. Heute eine neue Folge von Wieso, Weshalb, Warum, Why. Today a new episode of Wieso, Weshalb, Warum, Why. And it was David who asked me why there is a narrow gauge railroad on my layout. And this video is to answer his question. Also David hat mich gefragt, warum da eine Schmalspureisenbahn auf meinem Layout ist. Und diese Frage möchte ich heute beantworten. Und da David Englisch spricht, möchte ich das jetzt hauptsächlich auf Englisch abhalten. Macht es dann für mich doch ein bisschen einfacher, wenn ich nicht zwischen zwei Sprachen hin und her wechseln muss. Okay, as I said, David asked me why there is a narrow gauge railway on my layout, and I will continue in English because David is a native speaker English, or English native speaker, egal, doesn't matter, and it's a bit easier for me not to switch between two languages. Okay, David. Let's get started. So, this area here is one of the reasons why there is a narrow gauge railway on my layout, and especially this one is called in German Feldbahn. I don't know exactly the English name. It's you may compare it with the trains they built in the 19th century to bring the wood out of the forests, and so very narrow gauge, about 60 to 50 centimeters between the tracks, and these were used in factories, and near to the home of my parents there was a brick factory. And we children used to go there and look how they work, and how the ground was, the dirt was operated, and we visited the factory, and there might be the one or other brick with my signature in. So I took the chance when Bush brought this to the market. I purchased it and installed it on my layout. And the other reason is this one. So this the station. It's called Feldbahnmuseum, Narrow Gauge Museum, and this was inspired by the Frankfurt Narrow Gauge Museum. And they also operate trains in different sizes, but they are all adapted to this very narrow tracks, as they had been used in factories and in construction areas and so. And this is an Austrian train. That's the tracks a bit larger. They're about 90 centimeters to a meter, and they had been used in areas with low population to bring people to the next city and bring goods to the bigger stations and so. And I like these trains very much because you are closer to the technic than standing before a big steam engine running on main lines, and that's the fascination of the Narrow Gauge Museum in Frankfurt gives to me. And finally, there are three trains operating on this layout, or on this part of the layout. That's this one, the Austrian one, and this little one, it's called Decoville. It was produced in France. And the Frankfurt Feldbahn Museum really has this locomotive in original as the prototype. and that's a diesel engine. I'm not sure whether there is a real prototype or if it's only built to look like a real one. But these three logos are operating. This one is decoration and this one too. And I'm going to operate this with a Rocco Multimouse. I always try to show you. Yes, it's now, perhaps you can see it's felt, or the alternative is not V6 number 5. That's the steam engine in the foreground. I'll try to get it started. So, and it should connect the museum area with the zoological garden on my layout. So, I think I mentioned this in one of my earlier videos. So, okay, let's try and come back. And this is operated like a normal DCC. It's a normal DCC loco, and I think it's the only loco with DCC and no sound I have on the layout, so something special too. And now we come to the narrow gauge or Feldbahn locos. They are operated with a special decoder who is not in the locos. He is under the layout, and it gives me the possibility to switch off 4 tracks, and I can operate the locos with it. So I will give power to all 4 tracks. These are here the end of the track, this end of the track on the opposite side, and on the far end at this little station over there. You see here. And okay, I'll try to get them started. Back to the position. Okay. First loco came to stop, and the second one, this is 2 and 3, oops, no, it shouldn't do that, let's come out. So, and the yellow one also comes to work again, so. And stop again. So it's very easy to operate, and it's a little funny thing, and it's a small layout in the layout, to be honest, and this gives the possibility to detail more than on a big layout. You see it here. The coal is prepared for the locos, and parts are laying around. Like here, people are working there in the shed too. Oops. So, and of course, a railway museum must have a fest to get money. So, okay. Also someone busy at the barrow, and barbecue is ready. So, and that's just like the real Feldbahn Museum is acting. They have some some fests in normal times, not this year because of Corona, but they had a running session. Okay, so far, I hope I could answer your question, David. And if anybody else found something to ask, feel free to do it in the comments and I'll try to give an answer with a new short video. Okay, bye-bye.